Hello guys, welcome to the WebAppick channel. In this video, we'll learn how to create a Google Shopping product feed for your WooCommerce store by using CTX feed. So without further ado, let's jump in and learn how exactly we can do this. Right now, let's create a feed for our Google Merchant Center. To create a new feed, click on this little button. Once you've done that, you'll be presented with this content setting options. Let's go through these. For country, let's keep it at United States. Since we are uploading into Google Merchant Center, the template we need to choose is Google Shopping. Let's go ahead and do that. Let's give it a file name, Google Merchant. Here is the different file types you want your feed to show up as. Right now, you can see XML, CSV, and text, but I'll choose XML because I know that's the option Google Merchant would want. For variations, there are many ways you can show up your variable products. Right now it's chosen as all variations, but you can see there are other options you could choose as well. Language is English, that looks fine. Currency is USD, which is consistent with my country, so that's great. And these are the item wrappers and the single item wrappers for your XML feed. So these look great. Let's scroll down and look at the attributes. Since we've chosen the template for Google Merchant Center, our team has pre-populated all the necessary attributes needed for Google. As you can see under Google Attributes, we can see all the attributes needed right here. Let's go through some of these attributes. As you can see, we've got product ID, we've got product title, description, these are self-explanatory. And here, you can see you have got product category and Google product category. To find out what Google product category your feed might fall under, you can go to Google, search up Google Merchant Categories, and once you've done that, if you look into product taxonomy, you'll see all the different product categories available from Google right here. All these categories are also pre-populated here in our feed. So let's say I'm going to upload apparel and accessories. So as you can see, I can see the category right here. I'll choose that. Let's scroll down. Condition new, that's fine. Availability is something that's going to automatically be picked up. Under manufacturer, let's go with pattern and let's give it a brand name. Let's say these are all products from Nike. Here, as you can see, the regular price is already suffixed with USD and the sale price is suffixed with USD, which is consistent with our feed and our country, United States. So that looks all good. Great. Everything else looks great. We've got additional images, link, manufacturer, image. Perfect. Everything looks great to me. Let's go ahead, update and generate this feed. This will take a few seconds. And voila, as easy as that, as you can see, we have just created and generated our feed for Google Merchant Center. Now that our product feed is ready, now the next step is to log into Google Merchant Center and upload this feed there. So let's jump onto Google Merchant Center and sign in there. Right now, I've already signed into my Google Merchant Center account. Right now, let's go onto products and upload the feed that we have just created. Let's go to products. Here, if you want, you could add each of the products manually. Since we've just created the feed using CTX feed plugin, we're going to use upload multiple products and we're going to use one of these methods. So let's click right here. So right now it's asking us the information for our country of sale. Let's choose United States so that it's consistent with the feed that we have just created in our plugin. Let's choose United States. Let's choose our language. Let's find English. There we go. Here you've got the options of choosing free listing and shopping ads. For now, let's just focus on the free listings. Let's go ahead and click continue. Right here, you can see that you've got the option to name your feed and choose the input method. So let's give it a name. Let's say GMerchant. And here you can choose how you want your feed to be uploaded to your Google Merchant Center. Now, as you can see, there are a few options. As you can see, one of the options is Google Sheet, where you have the feed uploaded in your sheet and you can make the changes to the sheet accordingly to update your account. Next, we've got scheduled feed, and this is the option that you'll be using. Here, as you can see, you'll host a file on your site that'll contain the data and schedule a regular time for Google to update those products.
As you can see, this is exactly what we have in our site, and we're using our plugin CTX feed to create that feed for us. This upload option is basically using a file from your computer, and it regularly uploads the data to your account through SFTP or FTP or Google Cloud or any of those options. You also have the option of choosing Content API right here, which enables you to automatically upload product listing so you can make product more discoverable through shopping ads. For now, we're going to use the option that says Schedule Feed. Let's go ahead and choose that. Let's click Continue. Let's give it the same file name as well, just to keep it consistent. Let's say daily, fetch time at 12 o'clock, it's going to be updated. That's fine. Right here, you need to choose the file URL. To find this, go back to your site, and as you can see, this is my feed. This is the URL I need to choose. So I'm going to click here and copy it. Let's go back and paste it right here. Our file URL is pasted and ready to go. If your file is encrypted and locked by a username and password, here you have the option to provide that information to access this feed. However, since I have not password protected my file, this is not important for me right now. Let's go ahead and click on Create Feed. When you click on Fetch Now, you're basically prompting Google Merchant Center to look into your file as soon as possible instead of the scheduled time that you have just created when creating your feed. Since I've clicked on Fetch Now already, it's looking into my feed URL, and right now my file is being processed. There you go. Right now, as you can see, our feed file has been uploaded, and we can see all of our 8 products that has been uploaded into Google Merchant Center. Right now here you can see the error message where you can see some of the product data that we have submitted does not meet the product data specification. So let's scroll down, and here you can see all the different error messages. If you wanted, you can also download the error message report by clicking on the button right here. Also at the same time, you can just click on the drop down buttons here and see what the error messages are. We've got invalid URL in an attribute, we've got invalid attribute link as well. And here, let's take a look at this. It says invalid or missing required price. Right now, let's go back to our feed and check how exactly we can fix this issue. As you can see right here, it's telling us that one of our attributes is missing our price, and it's item 41. So let's copy that. Let's go back to our feed. Let's go to our feed right here. Let's take a look. Let's go control find item 41. As you can see, item 41 is men's hoodie with pocket. And if we scroll down, as you can see, there is no price available here. That's completely fine. Let's go back to our site and fix this issue. Let's go to products. So this is the product we're talking for, item 41, men's hoodie with pocket. As you can see right here, the error message was completely correct. There is no regular price or sale price for this product. Let's say it's $40 and the sale price is $20. That looks great. Let's update this. Once the product has been updated, let's go back to our feed. Refresh it so that the changes come across. Let's take a quick look at this feed just to be sure. All right, let's find our product. As you can see, now we can see the price and the sale prices here. That is perfect. Now it's time to go back to Google Merchant Center and update our feed once again. As you can see, we have this issue right here. Let's go ahead and reprocess this feed. This will take a little while. As you can see here, after I have reprocessed the feed, we still have some of the error message, but the error message with the price is already gone.
There you go, guys. Now you know how to create a Google Shopping product feed for your WooCommerce store by using our plugin CTX feed. If you have any questions or issues, you're welcome to reach out to us at support@webappick.com. I hope you guys found this video useful. Please leave a like and subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. I hope everybody has a good day. Thank you very much.